Friday, March 6th, we're 23 days into the 30-day legislative session, with 7 days officially remaining, although lawmakers only plan to use 5 of them. And that's because, in part, our scheduling has been so weird this winter. Snowstorms have forced the cancellation of 4 legislative workdays so far, including Thursday and Friday of this week. The legislature will resume Monday. Frankfurt got buried this week under 18 inches of snow, basically bringing the capital city to a halt. But a lot happened in the 3 work days that we did have. 3 bills are headed to Governor Steve Beshear for his signature. There's the so-called AT&T bill to deregulate local telephone service in Kentucky. There's the so-called beer bill to force the big brewing companies like Anheuser-Busch out of the distribution business. And there is a $132 million bond deal to help build a medical research center at the University of Kentucky, which is very good news for Lexington. A House bill that would extend civil protective orders to unmarried dating partners is for the first time getting a warm reception in the Senate. The Senate Judiciary Committee approved it this week. It's expected to get a full Senate vote early next week. Another House bill that's not going anywhere, one that would restore voting rights to convicted felons who have served their time, led to noisy protest at a Senate committee hearing this week. The protesters say it's time to finally move on the bill because most other states, unlike Kentucky, do allow felons to vote once they've finished their sentence. State police dragged the protesters from the room, and the bill's not expected to go anywhere. That's all for this week, and weather permitting, we'll see you next Friday.